guys, Glenn here. Got another video to show you about the Line 6 Helix. Now, if you're like me, a lot of guitar players out there, we have a lot of pedals, okay? Now, we like to use some of these pedals with our multi-effects pedal. Now, Line 6 Helix has a lot of great stomps that you can use inside the Helix, but some of you may have some other boutique stomps that you really like the sound of, and you can use these with the Helix. You can use the effects loops on the Helix to insert these into your chain or your patch, and I'm going to show you how to do that. I'm going to go through this one patch I've created, and I'll go through each block one by one. I'll show you how to program it from start to finish. Now, the cool thing about this patch is I'm not even using an amp for the distortion port. I'm not even using an amp in the Helix, okay? I'm using the pedal, distortion pedal, an external distortion pedal, hooked up to the effects loop. And then right after that, I've inserted a cab. Now, you don't have to use the Line 6 cabs, internal cabs. You can use impulse responses. Now, there's a lot out there to choose from. There's some that you pay for, but there's also a lot of free ones that are pretty good. I was surprised at what I found. But for this patch, I'm going to use one of the Line 6 cabs because it's really not fair to go through all of this and use an impulse response, because it's not going to sound like it sounds on my end when you get it and you program it. So anyway, here we go. Let's start to finish. I'm going to, at the end of putting this whole patch together, I will play for you what it sounds like. If you want to just skip all of this nonsense, to some people, they don't like to program it, you can just skip to the end of the video and hear how it sounds first, and then come back if you're interested in programming it. So anyway, let's check it out. Okay, so here's the Helix. It's in my board, and this here is the pedal I was telling you about. This is a Bogner Red Ecstasy pedal. Now, I love this pedal. It has the most organic distortions that I've ever heard that comes from a pedal. For those of you who are interested, this is a vocal processor. I have another vocal processor under the hood here, and this is a Line 6 G50 relay wireless. I highly recommend these things. They're great. So here on my Helix, I have this Bogner pedal patch, and I'm going to go through the controls here. Top left here, I have more drive. Then you probably can't see them. I'm not sure if you can see them in the video, but I have a more drive switch which engages a screamer. Then I have a univibe, chorus, delay, lead boost, an E flat drop, E flat button here that uses the pitch whammy effect. I've got a phaser, I've got a mod chorus echo, and I've got a clean amp. Now, this particular switch here does use an amplifier, and it is located up here in the patch, and it's a JC120. Okay, and then here's a detune feature that'll kind of give you that 80s detune sound if you want that. So let's go through these blocks one by one. I'll show you what each one is and show you all the controls so you can go through it one by one and program one of these patches for yourself. Okay, the very first thing is a pitch wham. You'll find that under the pitch synth section. You can use a mono one. By the way, the mono effects take less DSP power, so any effect you're going to be putting before your amp should be mono. That way you can save your DSP power. So you select the pitch wham. Now here's the settings. Heel pitch is -1, toe pitch is -1, and the mix is 100%. Now, you notice it's first in the chain. That's where it has to be for you to get a clear sound from the E-flat tuning. Now we're going to assign it to a switch. I have it assigned to this switch down here. The way you do that is you press this button up here and you go to foot switch assign, okay? And then you turn this knob, foot switch, and you assign it to whatever pedal you want. If you want to customize, you want to name it, you press the customize button. You can change the color of the LED, and you can change the name here. Okay, next in the chain, we have a phaser. This is script mod phase. Again, you can see it's in mono. You'll find that under the modulation category, script mod phase. Okay, now here's the settings. The rate is at 3.3, the mix is at 50%, and the level is at plus 1 dB. Okay, now we're going to assign that. That's second in the chain. We're going to assign that to this switch down here. And again, you do that. You press this button and you go foot switch assign. And this is foot switch 8. So I'm not going to turn it because it's going to change my names. See, when I turn it, it's going to change the name. I already have these names programmed, so I'm just going to show you the location of the knob here. You can turn it and set. You can set these locations anywhere you want, by the way. I just have them here. This is where I like them, so I'm going to show you where I have them set. Okay, next in the chain is a wah. I like the Veta wah. You notice I have the mix set at 31%. The reason I do that is because when the mix set at 100%, it really takes over your sound, okay? I don't like that. It sounds much more like a real wah with the mix down to around 30 or even 40%. Now here's the frequencies I have set. The FC high is set at 970 hertz. The FC low is set at 300 hertz, okay? And the level is at minus 0.1 dB. That can be zero. That really is not gonna affect the sound at all. And I have this third in the chain. Now it's automatically going to be assigned to the expression pedal when you turn it on. Okay, so you don't have to assign that one. Next in the chain, I have a noise gate. It's a very simple noise gate. Now this is a stereo noise gate. It could be mono. Like I said earlier, all the effects that go before your amp can be mono and save your DSP power. I don't know why this is set for stereo, but it is. But anyway, these are the settings. The threshold is set as minus 76 dB. The decay is at 10 milliseconds and the level is at zero. Okay, so that goes next. Following that, we have a compressor. It's the deluxe comp. You'll find that this is mono. You'll find that under the dynamics category, deluxe comp, okay? Here's the settings. Threshold, minus 37.1 dB. The ratio is 6.1. The attack is 38 milliseconds. The release is 200 milliseconds. The mix is at 100%. The level is at plus 7 dB, and the knee is set at plus 6 dB. Okay, now that doesn't have to be assigned to a pedal. Just like the noise gate, these don't have to be assigned. Next in the chain, I have a monitor. Now this is on all the time, but you'll notice right here, the gain switch changes, okay? Now what happens is, when I go to the clean amp, it turns the gain all the way down. So the clean amp, which is next in the chain, is a Jazz Rivet 120. But with this monitor distortion on all the time, with the gain set at zero, it's just like it's not on, okay? But it's still in the chain. So the way you do that is you press the, I'm gonna assign the gain level to this switch here. It says clean amp. Okay, this is how you do that. Press and hold this switch, and then you're gonna see it's automatically gonna be set to the gain parameter, all right? Then you can turn this knob controller, and you can put it anywhere on any switch, and you leave it for the type of latching. You can have either latching or momentary. Momentary means when you press on it, it'll engage the effect. When you let go, it'll stop the effect. But you want this on latching. The minimum value is 2, the maximum value is 3, okay? That means when I press this switch, the maximum value will make it 0. When I let go of the switch, it makes it at 2. Minimum means off, maximum means on, okay? And you'll notice right here, it changes. 0, switches on, switches off, changes to 2. Now, next in the chain, we have a split here. Now, the way you make a split is you just take any one of these blocks, okay? You press the action button up here, and it's gonna select that block, and you move it down, and it's gonna automatically create that separate path there, okay? That's how you do it. Now, I have a separate path here, and what I have in this path is a univibe, okay? That's assigned to this switch here, okay? And it is the ubiquitous vibe. Again, now this one's in stereo, and it's under the modulation category. You won't really hear a difference if you go mono or stereo, so I suggest you stay, again, everything before the amp will be mono, and it'll save you on DSP. Okay? And you can see this is routed before the amp. This is the clean amp, and these two effects are in a separate path, but they're hitting the front of the amp. Okay? So the big ubiquitous vibe I have here, the rated 4.5, intensity 3.2, it's in chorus mode, lamp bias is 5.0, the spread is 6.8, the mix is 58. The second page we have the level at plus 2.2 dB, okay? And it's assigned to this foot switch right here, which is foot switch 2. Okay, next we have a Scream 808. This is modeled after a tube screamer. And that's assigned to this switch that says more drive. That's under the distortion category. It's a mono. And these are the settings. The gain is 6.0. The tone is 6.0. The level is 6.7. And it's connected to this switch. And that is foot switch 1. Okay? And again, you can name these anything you want. You can change the color of the LED by pressing this button. Now we come to the amp. This is a Jazz Rivet. It's a model of a JC120. It's very good for clean stuff, jazz or whatever like that, or any type of clean tone. Drive is 1.8, bass is 4.0, mid 2.7, treble 4.7, presence 5.0, the channel volume is at 9, master is at 10, and the bright is at 0. Okay. Now, this amp is tied to this switch. It says clean amp. So when I press this switch, it's going to turn the clean amp on, but it's going to turn my Bogner pedal off. And the way it's doing that is it's turning on the effects loops here. I'm about to get to this here. So that's the amp. So that is assigned to foot switch 10. Okay? And right after that is a mod chorus echo. Now this is going to be stereo because it's after the amp. So it's going to really widen the sound. And I love this mod chorus echo because it's got a delay and also a chorus effect. And here are the settings. 400 millisecond is the time, 28 feedback, 155 hertz on the low cut, 9.5 kilohertz on the high cut. The mix is at 0. It's tied to the clean amp. Okay, so when you press the clean amp, it'll turn the mix up to 40%. When you disengage it, the mix will go down to 0. It's assigned to this switch here. This mod chorus echo is assigned to foot switch 9, right here, okay? All right, now we're gonna drop down to the bottom row, path 2. Okay. Now here's where I have inserted the Bogner pedal. Now first we have a send return, and it's send 1, okay? That's mono, send 1, okay? Now as I stated earlier, the Bogner is connected to the send and return jacks. They're located right here in the back of the unit, okay? So the first one is a send, and the send is plus 1, and the dry through is all the way off because I don't want any dry signal coming through this, okay? Now this is assigned to foot switch 10, which is the clean amp. You'll notice when I press it, they turn on. The clean amp is off, the effects loop is on with the Bogner pedal, okay? The next block is the return. Now this, the return level is at plus 1 and the mix is set at 50%, okay? And this one is also assigned to foot switch 10, which is the clean amp one. When I press the clean amp one button, it'll turn on the Jazz Rivet and it'll turn off the effects loop. Okay. Now this is the cool thing I was telling you about later. This particular patch for the drive, it's using the Bogner pedal, But you'll notice there's no amplifier here. I just have a cab. You can use any one of your pedals, your nice distortion pedals, just put a cab after it. And it's just like you have an actual amp. If you have a pedal that has like three gain stages, clean, maybe light crunch and heavy crunch, you set it up like this, it's like having a three-channel amp, all with that one pedal. So for the cab here, I chose the 412 1960 T75. Now that was the one that sounded as close as I could hear to some of the free IRs that are out there. And the settings on this cab are, I'm using a 57 dynamic. I really like the way that sounds. The distance is at one. The closer the mic is to the speaker, it's at one right here. The closer it is to the speaker, the fuller it's gonna sound. If you move this back away from the speaker, it's gonna get thin. So keep it right up close. Low cut is off, but you also have, if it's too muddy in the low end for you, depending on what kind of pickups you got, if you got some really high output pickups like that are in a Les Paul, you're gonna have a nice chunky low end. But on some other guitars, it might sound a little flubby. You can use the low cut to take care of that, okay? Then you got the high cut, that's also off. Early reflection is at zero, and the level is at 0 dB, okay? Next in the chain, we have a simple EQ. Now this is tied to the lead boost. You'll notice these two blocks here, that one, and there's a delay here. These two are tied to the lead boost. When I press this lead boost, it's gonna turn on this simple EQ, and I'm using it as a lead boost, and the level is at +4. I have it at +4 because that, to me, that's loud enough to cut through the mix and really jump out there without your sound man having to struggle to find your channel and miss half of your lead, especially when you're working with a sound man that's never mixed for you before. So again, it's tied to foot switch 5. This is switch 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay? And next, well, the volume pedal is next. Now, the reason why I've inserted a volume pedal here is because I don't want, and I'm going to demonstrate this, I don't want the volume pedal to control the delay trails in any of my delays or reverbs, okay? If I want to do some swells, some really cool delay swells, when I back that volume pedal down, I want my delay trails to keep going. So that's why you insert it here. If you insert it at the beginning of the chain, it's gonna cut off your delays, okay? So insert it here. It's automatically tied to the foot pedal when you insert it. Next is the delay. It's a ping pong delay and it's connected to the lead boost pedal. It gives me a really nice lead delay, okay? Not really oversaturated, but you know, just a couple of slapbacks. And these are the settings. 700 milliseconds is the time. The feedback is 17%. The scale is 50%. The speed is 10%. The mix is at 20%. The level is at 0. And the low cut is 100 hertz. The high cut is 8.9 hertz. And the delay trails are on. That means when you finish, you're coming out of your lead, press the lead boost, disengage it, your delay trails are going to keep on going, okay? Next is an EQ. Now, this one is also tied to the lead boost, but this is what it does. It takes the high gain frequencies and it brings it down 2 dB. See that? The EQ pedal is on all the time, but when the lead boost is on, I have the high frequencies boosted up to 3 dB. But when I press on the lead boost pedal, it drops the high frequencies down 2 dB to +1 dB, okay? That's going to take care of that really ice picky sound that you may have playing really high up on the neck, okay? And again, that also depends on your pickups. But now this is how you program it. You just hold this, any one of these parameters can be assigned to any one of these switches by simply holding it, and then you decide what foot switch you want. Again, this is number 5, which is my lead boost. It's on, the type is latching, and the minimum value is +3, maximum is +1. Remember, minimum means off, maximum means on, okay? Now, the pedal is on right now. It's at 1 plus one, which is the maximum. When I turn the pedal off, it goes to plus three, which is the minimum setting that I have, okay? Now we're gonna drop down to path 2A. And remember earlier, I showed you how to create that path. You just select a block, press the action button, and it'll highlight that block, and then you move it down, okay? And it'll go down to that bottom path, okay? All the way to the left here, I have a chorus. I like the modulation chorus. Now this is all stereo stuff here. Modulation chorus, that's in the modulation category. And here are the settings. Speed is at 2.5, depth is at 8.1, pre-delay 3.2, the wave shape is set for triangle, the tone is at 5, the spread is at 10, and the mix is at 50%, and the level is at plus 2 dB. Okay? That's tied to this pedal here, which is 1, 2, 3, foot switch 3. See that? Foot switch 3. Okay. This one's not even on. This delay is in here and it's not even connected to anything, I don't think. No, it's not. So anyway, just forget about that one. You don't need it there. I don't know why it's in there, but I put it there for some reason. I can't remember why right now, but this is my just a standard delay. It's not tied to the lead boost. If you just want some delay to beef up your sound, I have this one. It's a ping pong delay. The time is at 700 milliseconds. The feedback is 45%. The scale is 50%. Spread is at 10. Mix is at 36%. Level is at 0. The low cut is 100 hertz. The high cut is 8.9 hertz. And the delay trails are on. Okay. And again, this one is a stereo ping pong. Okay. And very last on this bottom row, I have a detune feature. Now, I learned this on the Line 6 boards just a few days ago. I was creating my detune sound with a chorus, but I read, if you get a pitch whammy, and again, I'm using a stereo pitch wham. If you set the heel pitch to minus one and the toe pitch to plus one, I have the mix set at 40%. Now, the position parameter here is very important, okay? If it's not at 44% for me, it doesn't sound right. And 1 or 2% higher or lower can totally change the sound of this. This, with these settings, you'll get a nice 80s pitch shifted type of sound. So anyway, last in the chain is my reverb, and it's a hall reverb. Decay set at four seconds, pre-delay at 0, low cuts at 166 hertz, high cuts at 4.3 kilohertz, the mix is at 28%, the level is at 0 dB, and the delay trails are on. Now, I want to make a comment about this mix. Anything higher than 30 or 40% I find is too much. It just makes you sound a little artificial. So that's the whole patch. Now I'm gonna let you hear what this sounds like. There's one thing I want to point out to you. You can move these splits anywhere you want, just like moving a block. Okay, you highlight the split, you press the action button, and it'll activate that split. You can move that thing anywhere you want. See that? I believe this is where I had it. Yeah. Do the same thing up here if you want. I want this split to be after the amp. I just highlight it and move it after the amp. So anyway, guys, that's it. I know this was a lot to take in, and I'm sorry I kind of went over it really fast. But like I said, if you want to stop the video and just copy the settings, you really don't even need to listen to my jibber jabber. You know, just stop the video, look at each block, and look at the settings. So now let me play this patch for you and noodle around a little bit. And guys, again, thank you for your support. Thank you.
Thank you.